Hello everyone and welcome back to No Man's Sky. We did one video yesterday. We actually did two because I went to the Breaking Benjamin and Disturbed along with Alter was there as well, and another band that I hadn't heard of, but they were all actually really good. Fantastic concert. It was great. Now here's the issue. You're probably saying, wait, two videos, but I only see one uploaded from yesterday. Well, here's the thing. I did the same thing I've been doing, streaming to Twitch, everything else. That way both can stay on top of things. But Twitch did not archive all of the video that we did yesterday. So, unfortunately, you guys missed out. It was pretty fantastic. Everyone missed out because I don't even think it said I was broadcasting, but nothing was saved. People can't rewatch it. It is fucking terrible. But we did a pirate. We got attacked by pirates. We lived. It was fantastic. It was a close fight. So the last place. So this is where we were or had just gotten to. Because blah blah blah, it's only telling me I can go forward. Anyway, so this was the last place we were at. This is what you guys missed. It was an entire probably hour and 45 minutes going to all six planets, checking stuff out, farming some more stuff up. We got a ton of money now, I'll show you. And we had just warped to, oh, we're in the wrong setting, that's why. We just warped here. And now Atlas Alpha. I had already renamed it because as soon as we jumped in, I edited the video, we renamed it. So this is where we're going to start. Unfortunately, you guys missed out on some stuff. But now that I'm thinking about it, the longer that we spend in systems and like there's nothing really of value or interest in them, it's going to take forever to get through this, and there's going to be so many videos over like an hour long and stuff. So what we're going to do is we're going to start heading into systems, checking the planets out, exploring a little bit, collecting some credits. If there's something there that we need to mine, we're going to mine it. Other than that, we're just going to keep progressing through the story. There's going to be a lot of background stuff. I might jump ahead a system or something off camera. So that's what's going on, because I don't want you guys to have to be like, oh, another hour video of where he just fucking sits around and looks at fucking plants and shit. So we're actually going to dive into it and see about getting all kinds of upgrades and new ships and everything else sooner. That way we can just focus on getting to the center and see what happens and actually see what the story is all about. The exploration stuff I can do on my own. So we're going to warp to Atlas Alpha. As we just warp through the corner of the space station. So I wonder what determines the length of the warp, really. Is it like this warp screen? So this is what we found. This guy right here. The Atlas interface. Big giant diamond. Now here's what's also interesting. We didn't go anywhere else, didn't do anything else. There's also a space station already here. Now, this is a space station I have not been to yet. So I feel like we're actually gonna go to the space station first, just so we can see what's in here, because this is a new ship. And I think this might be the tech aliens or the robots. So we're going to check and see what's going on. Or maybe I have seen this shape already. I can't remember. But also, since we had already warped over here once, what's my warp core at? Okay. So it just counted the fact that we had already been there and the name was already there. Which is interesting, but now we have that extra warp core, so it didn't waste one. And the reason why I have so many warp cores is that since we got all those blueprints, it is so easy to make warp cores now. This is new. What? What is this? Aha! Yeah, he looks like he should be from Daft Punk or something. I can't be the only one to think that, but he does. Now, what are they buying at a high price? Oh, look at that. +00. So they're buying it at normal rates. Iron at +1. Gold, -5. What? You should want gold there, guy. Heridium, +96%, but for only 6,000. And I can actually use heridium, really. Suspension fluid, I can make that easily. Plasma, so I can make that. Okay. So they're not doing anything really, but this guy. Oh, Corvax. Yeah, I know like none of their language. Okay. So as I approach the electronic life form, it instinctively starts to analyze me from head to foot. It chitters animatedly. Its head tilted to one side. The more it studies, the more the facility's resource vault consumes what my scanner suggests are silicate elements. Okay, so silicate elements. So he's going to want silicate, right? Mild disappointment. Or not. But at least I learned words. So rare and warning. So let's check and see what these guys are selling or got. And they're like dinosaur ships. Let's see what's going on with them. I still know nothing. What are they ships? 28. 4 million! Ha! Ha! I scoff at your ridiculous prices. But what are you buying my stuff at? Ooh, they're buying it at +104. But I can't make those. Which is interesting. I'm buying zinc at barely any. What is he selling? Suspension fluid. Okay, power reserve. Power reservoir. Okay, so if I can find a bunch more power reservoirs, that'd be good. That'd be. Holy crap! 72? What is that? Magmox. Okay, we gotta find Magmox. Wherever the hell that is. Me and my awesome looking ship. Mostly just looks awesome looking. Design, really. Yeah, we'll just plow through the back of his thing. No problem. Okay. What is this asteroid made of? Is it made of that stuff I want? We'll find out. Copper. Copper. More copper. So it's just full of copper. That should be zithamian. Yep. Alright. Distress signal detected. Distress signal? Distress signal. Wait. What is that? What was that blinking thing? Oh yeah. Okay, so these are some more. Let's see if we can help these guys out. Probably not gonna survive. Okay, so what I learned from my last encounter is pretty much just hang on to one ship. Oh, Shields are down. We need to recharge the iron. Oh, that didn't recharge him that much. Oh, aluminum. We need aluminum. Okay. Not 100% on the target reticle stuff. Just because it seems like when it says lead them and then you do actually lead them, it doesn't always work. Journey milestone. For what? I'm trying to get space pirates. Ooh, we need a shield recharge, quick. We're actually losing health. Actual health. Can't figure out where they are. There's one. See, it says they hit there, but it... Oh, shit. Okay, I'm out of ammunition for that. Fuck. Fuck me. Ooh, this is not good. Oh, repair? Okay, so it looks like we're down to just one weapon. Where is it? Is it? Okay, there it is. Can we get lucky? No, we did not get lucky. God damn it. Death by laser. Okay. So that sucked. We need many more materials. And we need ship upgrades, but I don't want to necessarily upgrade this ship for combat because it doesn't have a lot of slots. I'm more concerned about upgrading this ship for... Okay, there we go. Mostly just like travel. So, but in any case, we got... one ship left, so I think we did pretty well, considering that's the most ships I've ever fought. The first pirate encounter I did, it was just three ships to my one. I don't remember off the top of my head how many that one was, but I think that one was like six or something. Oh, look at that, more red stuff. A lot more red stuff. What is that? Crazy. Oh, that is crazy. Look at that. Wow. Wow. There's all kinds of levels and everything. Warp cell. Warp cell. Okay. Why do those look like 8-bit llamas or something on there? Okay, let's see what happens. Whoa. Oh. Oh, okay. I have no... Oh, man, that's a fourth language to learn? Son of a bitch. It is alien, unlike anything I have ever seen before. I should be afraid, but an inexorable? Yeah, pull draws me towards the heart of the construct. A need to know. There's a remnant of the Atlas. It welcomes me. It knows what I am. It offers a promise of true understanding. The intent burns in me. I will peer into the structure of causality and know its existence. If it is real or some incalculably vast simulacrum, sure, authored by other intelligences. Refused? No, we are going to accept. I will accept this. The sky is deep and full of wonders, and the path. Blah, 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 blah. Atlas Stone. Wait. Was that it? An extremely rare item often associated with ancient monolithic sites. That was it? That was legitimately it. There is nothing crazy. Nothing. Yeah, we're actually gonna add that in. We're actually gonna move a bunch of this stuff down as well. Okay. But seriously, that was it? Zinc. 100 zinc for shield. Oh. I need zinc for both. Tau, Sigma. I'm pretty sure Tau is the best or better. Stamina. Wait, I can do plus 3? Well, why didn't it tell me I could just do plus 3? Oh. Okay, well, at least that kind of helps with my fucking thing. But seriously, is there nothing else to do here? Just push me back. Okay, I can't get any closer. That's so dumb. Well, I was hoping there would be more to show you guys, but apparently there's not in here. What are these things? What? Are they just disappearing? What? This has to be something if I can just come up, walk up to them, and they disappear. Like, why would these be in here, if that's the case? And like, what, like, these red lines? I mean, come on. Like, what are these pedestals for? Like, what is this for? Can I put something there? Like, nothing works? This doesn't make any sense to me, this area. Alright. Now, I'm going to the galactic map. Anomaly detected. Oh, geez. Another Atlas interface? Oh, God. What was I doing? We're checking to see how many planets are here in this system. It doesn't say how many planets there are. Okay. So, I see one. I see two, and those are the only space lanes I'm seeing as well. So a two system, a two planet system. Okay, so we're just gonna check them out real quick, and then I guess you could say GTFO. Now, I wonder how many of these Atlas things I have to go to before I can get, like, an Atlas pass. Or do I need to continue going to the center of the universe to get an Atlas pass? See, and these are things I just don't know. This one's got a lot of water on it. It's red. Rocky. Looks like tree type stuff. Is that what I thought it was, or did I just land from the goddamn thing? Nope, that's what I thought it was. Sentinels. Threatening. Okay. That's a new one. Korvac word for toxic. I should have just gotten this one first. Oh, but Korvac word for traveler. Oh, but here's the thing. This is. Oh shit! I don't know a lot of Korvac words, so this is not going to be super easy to get into. Calm. Okay, well, I know calm. So wait it out. A reward materializes. Looks like I knew the one word I needed. Calm. My standing with Korvac has increased. Korvac casing. Alright, now we're just gonna get some quick scans. We're not going to scan absolutely everything or go looking for everything because, like I was saying, that it's going to be a little while. Okay, we've already discovered that. We'll scan this thing. And these. And then this rock. And that other rock, because apparently all rocks are different. I mean, technically they could be like different compositions and make them like different, but they all give the same material, so it's kind of like, it's iron. No matter which way you look at it, it's going to be the same thing. So, but it does say there's something in the water. Can I actually land in the water? We are about to find out. No, you cannot. See, it says it's literally right there. Just let me land! Thank you. Alright, now I will be right back. I hear my dog barking. Alright guys, we are back. Had to take care of some stuff real quick, but now we're here. Okay. Let's get back into this. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, 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 blah. So, in the time that I was gone, literally walking over there, coming back, because this planet is threatening, a sentinel found me and killed me. And I was the dingus who forgot that as soon as you land in your ship, you don't sit in your ship, because I would have been safe in my ship. You get out of your ship. I should have gone and paused it. But that's not the case. So if you were wondering what it's like to die, this is what happens. You get a marker forever placed. And I guess someone else can find it as well. Of where you died. So now, if someone finds this planet in with the ever unlikely circumstances that it would be that they find it, they could find my death marker. And if they do, I would want them to screenshot it and send it to me. Because that would be awesome. I mean, not awesome that I died, just awesome that they found it. So, here's... No. That's what I wanted. Why is this underwater? And again, it's just cool that your jetpack is infinite underwater. And you can also start scanning that I've seen and just look at something else as well, and it will actually keep scanning, which is nice. Okay. But this death marker makes me sad, so we're going to leave this and see what else is here real quick before we bail out of this planet and go somewhere else. If you guys can hear outside, dogs are outside barking up a storm. And again, how are you supposed to know what you look like if they say that people can find you? But literally, no one has been able to really find anybody except for, like, those two other streamers. And even then, they couldn't see what they look like. They tried to, like, cause damage to the ground. And no one could see anything, so... kinda having this sneaking suspicion that, in fact, there is no finding anyone else. There is no co-op, and there is going to be no multiplayer, but... I mean, they even said that they added, like, tools into the game to allow you to find other people and, like, encourage it. But if no one just can, then what the hell's going on? So that is disappointing for me, because this game would be so much better and so much more, I guess you could say, even more enjoyable if there were more people to play with. Okay, so we're going to name this planet... What are we going to name this planet? Blah, 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 blah. Ha, 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 ha. Grumblum. Because there are no animals. So we're actually not going to spend that much time here. We're actually going to head out of this system after we go to the other planet. But what we are going to do is also add these two new warp cells that we got. So we're at 80%. So that's four warp jumps. We're going to head over to this other planet in the system, since apparently there are two of them. And we can't rename the Atlas interface, because I feel like I want to go to the second Atlas station or interception, because I feel like going to the second one will give me my Atlas pass. Because the game's kind of probably like, well, you're not that big and fond of Atlas, so you don't need a pass yet. But then again, or do I need to continue to travel to the center to meet up with those people to get an Atlas Pass? I don't know. That's the thing. So I kind of do just want to, like, jump over to the second one and see what's going on. And then, like, figure out what else to do. What is that? Like it's just a rock. Yeah, it's just a rock and some sand. Let's do a scan. No, I'm not even seeing any like question marks or anything like that. But these are definitely some interesting buildings compared to what we've usually seen. Peaceful climate, average, lacking, none present. Okay. And there's no plant life. So literally this system is just all about the Atlas. Scan it. Let's go. Can we scan it, please? Am I not allowed to scan it? Oh, wait, what? Wow, look at that! Pearls! Fuck. It said it was average. It said it wasn't threatening or hostile. Already known, and like I am hitting the point to where like I'm not finding a lot more upgrade blueprints as I used to. Yeah, see, already known. See, so that definitely does explain why I couldn't interact with that thing. Yeah, see, already known. But we can always use more plutonium. Even get those little spikes of plutonium. Okay, but the fact that there are pearls, or those pearl things, is interesting. I want to collect more of them, but actually, I am going to collect more. God, they're fucking everywhere. I would have thought the pearls would have been, like, in the water. But I guess not. Can I scan it now? No, I can't. Okay, we have stuff to recharge, that's for sure. Definitely in multi-tool. Especially these grenades, because these grenades are so, so nice. Alright, what do we got here? Long ago, it seems an automated distress went unanswered. Alright, 1 to 2. Plus 1. Plus 4. No. Oh no, times 2, times 4. Right? 2, 4, 6 times 6 is 24. 2, 4, 6, 8. No. Yeah. No, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 6. 6 on top of that is 720. We've done that one before. It took me a second. As I fly up into the air with my... Oh, God. Ooh, that was interesting. I thought for a second there the game was going to crash. I haven't had a crap... I was about to say I haven't had a crash yet. Because I was about to say it, God... Shut up. Fucking... Okay. Hang on... I have no idea what made it crash at all. And if you guys have never seen the loading screen, here's the intro. It's going to drop us right back into here. Right where we were, and now we've got to go recollect those, but we will get those in a minute. Because now that I know that my grenades weren't all the way charged, it will make that fight that much easier. So let's... do this again. Interact. Same numbers. 720. Okay. And see, here I am stuck in the air again, and it's going to drop me down. Now, if we click this again, it crashed again. So, that tells me I am not allowed. I am not allowed to access that, is what that tells me. I am not allowed. Not allowed. Can't have it. Nope. Not at all. It's not for me. And now it's a red intro into like kind of pink. So we are just going to do this then. Collect a bunch more of this. Go back to here, charge this again. Check my exosuit, pearls are not there. We're actually going to go back in, just get the distress signal, not collect... Oh, wait, can I collect it before we do the space thing? No, I just can't collect it at all.
God damn it!
Oh, it's literally, I have played 23 hours of this game and have not had it crash once. But now, all of a sudden, it's just crashing. And 23 hours, you're probably thinking, but there are 23 hours worth of videos up. That's because I've also let it be open in, like, the background. Like, in between takes and everything else. So that's probably also what's going on with it. So, okay. We're just not even going to collect it at all. We're going to do the distress signal. We're going to talk to the Korvac. And then we're going to leave. They can keep that blueprint. No concern of mine. I will probably find it somewhere else. Now, what is that question mark in the bottom left? It kind of looked like it could have been a drop pod. So we're definitely going to go check that out because I want more suit spaces. More suit spaces. Okay. Korvac. I don't know what he's talking about. The electronic life force break reading suddenly slows. Personal data, which is like columns distributed data show is power levels. Power levels. So Thamian, we're gonna need it. What is there? Thamian right outside. Could be. No, that's plutonium. Wait, what is that over there? Is that what we need? Yes, it is. We need aluminum. What? I thought we just charged all this. No, we didn't. That was before it crashed again. You're right. You are right, computer. Because I have found that once you put some upgrades into your multi-tool for this grenade thing, it is very useful, but it didn't give me any any materials that I actually needed. What the fuck? Because this is what we're trying to make. And we're at 232 of 800. So we're going to need to find more of those. And you know what we're also going to do? Depending on how many suit slots I have a lot of suit slots. Now I'll show you what I was talking about with these grenade things. See? Dead. Oh, I missed that shot. Dead. Fuck, I missed. I missed again. I will not die. There. Already known. Already known. But here's the thing, it like glitches out and still says that there's something there. Or that there's still that elite, which is nice. Well, it's good because then you can do this. Because technically you're still wanted, but there's already still this guy here. And as long as you can keep it to where he can technically like fake see you, you can keep doing what you were doing. To like make him mad while you still have like the bounty thing. And you won't get in trouble and there would be no reinforcements called. Okay. See, so now... now we've got the inventory full of these things. Okay. So that's really all I wanted to do, was get a bunch of these to see how much these would go for once we go to the a different system. But if I remember right, also, the space station when we were first there was buying these at a very, very hefty price. Maybe there's a health regen if we're lucky. Yeah, see, we already know that one. Okay, but I did want to see what was over here real quick, and thankfully enough, it's on the way. What the heck? What was I stuck on? That was weird. Okay, here's actually a trade terminal right here. So we'll see how much they're selling for real quick here. All right. Plus one, but that's still pretty good. 166. Thousand. Because these are easy enough to get. So we're actually going to... let's check and see. Because we need... what did we need? We need it... was it aluminum? Were we just mining for aluminum? Yes, we were just mining for aluminum. So we are actually going to buy their aluminum. Because we need it. I mean, it's not a lot of aluminum, but, you know. Every little bit counts. But we're definitely going to stop and see every time we see a chunk of aluminum. And what is that? That's iridium. That's iridium. Okay, but what I was going to do was we were actually going to rename this planet. Why is my caps lock on? My caps lock just turns on for no reason. Pearl. That way I know exactly off the top of my head that this has pearl. But what the heck is this element? Or is it just... is it just rock? Is it just a rock? Yeah, it's just a rock. Damn it. Okay, there's something right there. But that's not the silver color that we need. Oh my god, this is gonna take forever. We're going up. We're going up and back down. It is still definitely quite a ways away. Oh wow, it was like legitimately on the other side of the planet. Still quite a ways away. Okay, there we go. Landing initiated. Oh, this is a, this is meh. I mean, this is a funky looking ship. I've never seen this pattern on, like, these wings, though. And that is pretty much a TIE fighter wing, if I have ever seen one. What's it look like on the inside? 20 slots. It has far more, does far more weapon damage than mine does. But let's see what's broke on it. This is broke. This is broke. These are broke. This is broke. Hyperdrive's broke. Cannons are broke. Other... oh, wait a second. This already has a secondary warp. Ooh, so what would I need to fix to get it to work? The pulse engine and the hyperdrive. But I'm about to actually build... Oh wait, Sigma, that's only the first one. No, and the fact that it's only got one extra slot... I mean, I could have, but no. Alright. Emergency activated as I climb on board. The hologram appears before me. The lights is... lights in the mask, it wears seem white and dim. Functional technology. And now construct one of these advances myself. What is it? Oh, look at that, actually. So, warp reactor theta. Huh. Theta. Okay, I need a goddamn ton of gold and a goddamn ton of emerald. Interesting. Very interesting, actually. Man. Damn it. Is that another crashed ship? That is another crashed ship. What the heck? This is interesting. Well, it's with all these crashed ships over here. This is literally the most crashed ships I've seen in one area ever. Okay, a charm, isotope, cargo. Cannon damage data, already know. Cockpit is pristine, devoid of damage, save for caused by the deceased pilot's impact. Functioning technology. I discover useful tech. Oh, membrane theta. Oh, son of a bitch. Standing with quarterback decreased. Okay, this only has 18 slots. It's not better than mine. Alright. Alright, I guess. I mean, standing with the different races has become now, it's like... Eh! Cool, but... It just seems like in so many of the areas you're gonna find so much stuff that increases reputation. It's like, I can afford to not have reputation. See, look, that was only two. But then I feel like I'm getting more out of the mining laser. But then again, it seems to work better for some stuff and then not others. And I'm pretty sure aluminum, if you mine it on Earth, It doesn't look like what it looks like when it's foil. Because I basically feel like I'm mining a giant ball of aluminum foil. Is what it feels like. Because I severely do want a new hyperdrive. So that we can see how much extra distance we can travel. Oh wow. This goes deep. Holy shit. Oh damn, how far down does this go? Oh, probably all the way into this mine. Looks like there's a vein. I wonder how far down I can actually shoot into a hole into the ground. Because I do like how you can actually destroy chunks of the planet. Why does that look like water? Because it is water. What? Wait a second, so does that mean I have been able to get to places that I couldn't have been able to get to on the other planets because I didn't have this thing? To blast through the rock? Is that what this is telling me? So now what's buried underground then? See, like, well, this is a bad example because you could just walk through this, apparently. Fuck. Where was I going? Or where did I come from? Oh, goddamn it. So let's see if this actually works. God damn it. That I could have known this so long ago. It's so useful to know that you can just blow the fucking ground up. Again, but you know, there's no tutorial, nothing really told to you. It's kind of figure out all the stuff you can do on your own. And there I go, just fucking out of here. Alright. That's what that's telling me. Let's do a system scan. See what's going on. Abandoned building detected. Now, I don't want to. I really don't feel like it. I feel like we need to explore more. And this one is only 3 jumps away. So a new system for us to explore. Atlas Alpha completed. Man, it got dark really quick. It's about to storm. Space anomaly. Whoa, this is new. Space. What? 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 What is the space anomaly? What is this? What is this? What is this? What is this? Seriously? What is this? We did it! We found them! This has to be them. This has to be. This literally there's no other explanation. That guy legitimately looks like Daft Punk. Like, no joke, 100%. Yep, there it is. Nada! We did it! It's a good thing we went this way. A rare linguistic form. Pleasure. Nada Divergent Corvax assistance offered. Route to Galactic Core. Reconnect with Atlas for guidance. Resources for journey. Yes or no? Okay. Okay, so find a shortcut to the center or resources to aid exploration. I want resources. Oh, but we already know that! Damn it! Okay. I kinda don't want to, but fuck it. I'm tired of getting blueprints that I already know, especially from, like, Nada. Apparently the two people that set you on this entire journey, I think maybe they did, or we were just asked to find them. It's been so long. But if that's really all they're gonna give me is a fucking blueprint that I already know, then we're gonna ask for a shortcut. Find a shortcut. The alien locates a black hole. What? Alright, Polo, what you got? Friends everywhere, if only you know where to look. Friends in all shapes, all sizes, all places. Okay. The shorter entity, a Gek, has a jocular air about him. They idly wipe grease splattered hands on their suits as they address me. Some sort of engineer. Shouldn't it be he? Whatever. To my surprise, they speak my language. Other life forms have treated me with amused indifference, but Polo treats me like an equal. They are curious about my travels, about the sentient species I have seen. If I have met life forms they have not, they hope that I will share my experiences. Yeah, transmit data. Pole pulls over the data, muttering bitterly at beginnings that they are already familiar with, cheering at those. Yes! We did it! We did it! Atlas pass level 1! Are you serious, one carbon? One carbon? Oh. What is this? 19 slots. 17 slots. Fuck yes. We're taking it.
Look at that.
And we got a new gun. Nice. Nice. So now we can make the Atlas pass level 1. And we found a black hole. So now... shit, we're gonna need... We're gonna need iron. Wait, how many planets did they say were in the system? Okay, so we will actually go to this one because it's the farthest away real quick. Oh, there we go! That makes me happy. Atlas pass level 1. So now we can actually open all those containers and crates that are on the planet's surface. Or that are on the planet's surfaces. Why are there two trading posts right next to each other? Is that a big chunk of gold that I'm seeing? What's up with this planet? Irradiated, standard, abundant, deficient. No, it's emerald. Okay, we already know this, yes. Okay, because we're gonna need apparently 1,000 of this before we can get that Theta warp drive. Okay, yeah, this mine's much faster than the other one I had. So that's actually fantastic. Oh wait, what? We need an iron. That's right. Okay, yes, much faster. Okay, but here's the thing. Yes. Okay, we know. You're probably thinking, yes, we know it mines faster. Yes. Can we get to making some stuff that we haven't been able to make before? And I would say, yes, you are correct. Let's do that. Atlas Pass version 1. And let's see what are inside these crates now. Because I am very, very interested. After we hit this save. Okay, what's in it? Electron vapor. Okay. Now, I've seen these things before, but not nearly this big. And it seems like they shouldn't be that big because their textures are kind of like out of whack for being as big as it is. So... But that is actually fantastic that now we have the ability for the Atlas passes. Oh, wait a second. And since I made it, it's just sitting in my inventory? It's not something that I have to remake like those bypass chips? What is that? It's more emerald. Again, it's like sometimes the grenade will give me stuff and sometimes it won't. Oh, here's some more of this. Can't kill it. You see, now this is the stuff. I still have no idea what it is. Already known. Restore shields. I need to restore health. That's what I need, because I just realized my health is still low. Analyze data. Now, these messages I've seen have started to repeat. Wow, it is going to storm. It got really dark. Life support already known. Yes, I know. I already know it. I've already installed it as well. I've got both of them. I've got the 2 and the 3 installed. There's health. Oh, but it didn't restore all of them. That's interesting. Usually it's like a full health restore, kind of. Sometimes, maybe, possibly, not 100% sure. And then we'll scan this thing, I already scanned that. But I have not scanned that yet, since it's all wiggly. Alright. And that is going to do it for this episode, guys. Got quite a bit done, I would think. Got through a system. Got some excellent blueprints. We found and went into, finally, that Atlas station. Didn't think... the game finally crashed, so we've seen that happen. We found NADA and POLO, and we got our Atlas Pass number one. So now we should be able to get into and open a lot of things that we haven't been able to before, which is fantastic. And now we're just going to need the Atlas Pass version 2 and 3. Not 100% sure where that is going to be. Just because I'm not exactly sure what constituted Polo giving me the Atlas Pass version 1. I wonder if it's based off how many systems I've been to, how much stuff I've scanned, and all that. Which would kind of make sense, just because, you know, why would you give me a pass for Atlas that apparently the path I'm trying to follow if I'm not supplying them with, you know, enough data or doing the core function of the game, which is exploring and cataloging. So that's kind of just where I'm at with that pass idea. And we need more emerald. For sure. Radiation protection. Turns out, because we are just going straight for this warp reactor Theta. That's what we're going to go to. We're going to go for Theta. We're not going to go for Tau. We're not going to go for Sigma. Even though I gathered all the fucking nickel and was getting aluminum for it. But we don't need it now. We need emerald and gold. So... that's what we're going for. I am going to farm all of that before next time. That way we can just install it and put it on and see how it's going to work. And go from there. So I will definitely say this is starting to get... I would say it's starting to get more interesting, but there's still so much left untalked about and still unknown that it's at the point to where I am still severely confused. But we'll pick it up next time. We're probably not going to be here. I'm probably going to hit the other planets and everything else. But before we go, we are going to rename these planets and the system. Now, we are going to name this planet, since it is kind of like jungle-ish, and I kind of get like a Vietnam feeling with all the plants, we're going to name it Nam. And then for the system, I don't know if we're going to see Polo or any of them again, because it looks like that station could travel. We're just going to call it Polo Alpha. Just in case if they are like somewhere else, then we can do like Polo Alpha, NADA Alpha, and then if we see him again, Polo Beta, NADA Beta. That way we know where in the system that if we need to travel back through here, we know which system that they showed up in, and it's kind of an easy way to figure out what's going on. So, that's been enough talking. That's time to end it. Thank you guys for checking it out. Thanks for sticking through this journey with us. Again, it's a bummer that there was a video that was entirely lost that should have been there. There was some stuff that you guys did miss out on. But you kind of got to see the space battle. I got my ass kicked on that one. So, not exactly looking the best for me, but hey, it's what happens. But anyway, guys, thanks for checking it out. If you like what you see, hit that like and subscribe button, and I will see you guys next time.